basically
Mm-hmm.
as we will be more towards the focus will be learning the data stack first. So basically when you learn the data part of it, like what exactly are there. So once we cover the data things, so there will be few things that we will do on the proc side. So basically how it goes, your
Okay.
data step and a proc step, it goes hand in hand. So the areas which are the initial things we can learn from the data, and then as I was the other day I was showing you regarding the proc contents, what is there, so we can learn those areas so that anything related to how the what you do in the data, and then how you can see like which are the variables, what are the variable types, and how you print the data. We are going to learn this, and then we are going to do something on the part of like if then else and do loop. So these all things we will try to capture for today's session,
Okay.
mostly on the data part today. So basically
All
the
right.
first thing, if you just have a look over here, as we were discussing like how the sample size. Now for the timing, few things we will be ignoring because these things will be covered in the interim, like maybe in the sixth, fourth or fifth class. So few things will be there,
Okay.
so that because that requests other things to cover, so we're going to do those lines. So
Okay.
if we go over here, like if you see that, firstly we need to we are going to do something like if we need to import any data, then how we can do so. So firstly the one part that we are going to capture. So the other day we learned how to create a library, what is the work folder,
Yes.
and the initial of how a data looks like, what a length, and today more on the formatting part of it, and then basically how you can import your data and everything.
Okay.
Okay, so the if you
Okay.
just if I go over here, so basically the first part we can do is like we can start with this. You have a data option, then you have an in file option, then you see the here is called an input, then in the input you have something, and then they're calculated another variable. So now if we need to, if we need to import our data, or if you have your data in some other location and from there you wanted to import it, the way we are going to do is like we are going to write a in file. So for any programming language, when we need to mention that, when we need to read an external data source, basically it can be in the form of a CSV, it can be in the form of a text file, or even it has a capability when we import our use another format that is like a, that is called a proc import, that will also be covered. So which we can also use Excel file to read the contents. So basically
Okay.
these are the there will be some format by which we can read the lines. The next will be like we are going to run all this, so don't worry, because just I'm giving an overview and then we are going to run from in a SAS window. Second part is like as
Okay.
we as now don't these are the proc steps. So basically they are giving you an idea of a proc and a data step. So these piece we have covered last time. So I'm just moving away from this. So basically first is today we have to learn how to import the data, and then basically for the SAS stems. Now you see there are few naming conventions. So in a SAS name, because why I'm using this ebook, because this will be really useful when you do a base SAS certification. So I have a lot of materials regarding to that, so I'm trying to use those pieces so that you get your understanding clear.
Okay.
Okay, so now when you need to write a say data set name, so there will be few conventions that you need to keep it in mind. So basically you can't start with an underscore, or you can't start with a number. So there will be few of the things so which we need to understand, which are the valid format or the valid kind of a nomenclature which you can use. Over here if you look into it, see valid SAS name is look something like this, but if you write something with a number, it should not be the thing. If you use any blank to start, that also should not be the thing, and also you should not start with any of those special characters. So it's advised like whenever you write a SAS data set name, it should not have within that no blank statement. Like if you are writing day 2. So day 2 should be together. If you cannot give day and give a blank and write 2, so that is not accepted. And even like if you wanted to use few things, you can use the underscore sign. So that is a valid format.